This is hot water and this is cold water. Now I am taking a color. And I'll just put pinch of color in both. And you have to notice the difference in dissolution, in which the color will dissolve fast. This is cold water, this is hot water. You can check the temperature even. It was hot water, you can see that. There is steam which is coming out. It is hot water. This is sample of cold water. Chilled water is there. So dissolution is faster in hot water rather than cold water. It shows that particles of water are moving very fast in hot water. As they are having more amount of kinetic energy, particles are moving fast. There is random motion like this. When particles are moving fast, dissolution will be faster. So color gets dissolved in this sample very quickly. You can see from this side how the particles are moving. You can see the streaks which are evolving out. But in this case, dissolution rate is very less. You can see that color is at the bottom. It is not dissolved well. So from this activity, we can prove that in hot water, dissolution rate is faster. In cold water, dissolution rate is slow. So hot water has more kinetic energy. This thing you can observe. When your mother is cooking food in kitchen, when she cooks something hot, like she is cooking manchurian, she is cooking noodles, at that time you get the smell of that food in your room. But when she is making mango ice cream, she is making something chocolatey or something which is not hot, you are not getting the smell of that in your room. Why so? Both the things can be your favorite, but you are not getting the smell of cold food. But you are getting the smell of hot food. Reason behind is, when there is heat energy involved, you are giving heat to the food, you are giving heat to the water, the particles are moving faster. Faster is motion of the particles of medium, it reaches faster to your nostril. So air is carrying the vapors of hot food faster to your nostril as compared to cold food. In this activity, we have two conical flasks with water at same temperature. Now I am taking two things. One is color. I'll put a pinch of color inside. You can see the dissolution. Rate of dissolution is very fast. I have not used stirrer, but it is dissolving itself. You can see the streaks which are coming out. You can even see the shadow, that how streaks are moving out. And in second, I'll take honey. I'll just pour a drop of honey inside. And you have to note its dissolution. Is it dissolving as quickly as color was dissolved? No. It settles at the bottom. You can see it settles at the bottom. It is not dissolving. Why there is difference in dissolution? You can see here density of honey is too much as compared to density of that color. As there is binding forces that are present between the particles of honey, strong binding forces are there and it needs time to break the bonds which are present between the particles of honey. So rate of dissolution in case of honey is less as compared to dye. Today we are going to perform activity 1.6. In that, we will study about the arrangement of solid, liquid and gases. In gases, particles are loosely bind with each other. Just like these are forces of attraction which are weakest. After that comes liquids. In liquids, particles are arranged like this. And in solid, there is tighter arrangement of particles. Particles come closer to each other. So it is very difficult to break the bond which is present between solids. It was easy to break the bond which was present in liquid. And it is comparatively very easy to break the bond which is present in gases. It can be broken like this. 1.7, we have to take three things. One rubber band, one piece of charcoal, and one iron nail. We will take a hammer and try to change the shape of these three things. You know, on hammering, shape of rubber band will not change. But on hammering, shape of this piece of charcoal will change. It can be converted to powdered form. On soft hammering, shape of iron nail will not change. Although we know if we will tightly hammer it, its shape can change. So it shows the bonding which is present between different types of solids. The particles of these type of solids, which are amorphous solids, like chalk, like charcoal, can be broken easily. But the bonding which is present in rubber particles, it is elasticity. It can't be broken easily. And the particles of iron nail are strongly, tightly bind. Its shape will not change so easily. Activity 1.8, we will see when water is flowing down and you are trying to cut it with your finger. What happens when you are trying to cut it with your finger? You are trying to break the forces which are present between water molecules. As flow increases, you are feeling more forces. More forces means you are trying to cut it with your hand and you are feeling more forces. If flow is less, you are feeling less forces. So the forces which are present between water molecules increases as the tap water flow increases.